Zillions, welcome back to another video. For this one, I am going to be cleaning out my entire wardrobe using the KonMari method. For those of you who don't know, Marie Kondo is a Japanese woman whose cleaning method went virally popular in the last few years. In short, her method says you keep things or discard things based on whether or not they spark joy. Another thing that's special about the KonMari method is you don't organize by room of the house, you organize by type of object. So first you have to do all of your clothes, shoes, outerwear, then you move on to books and papers, then you do miscellaneous, and lastly, when you've honed your skills the most, you can do sentimental items. If you want more information and some details, she's written two really good books that I have read before. I can link them in the description. Not sponsored, but I'll still have them there if you want. So, like I mentioned, the KonMari method is based on the principle of whether or not something sparks joy, but I'm going to be adding a few additional categories for myself. Number one is the utility function. Even if my business casual pants, for example, don't spark joy, I kind of have to keep them. Number two, whether or not something actually fits. If it's too big or too small and I can't wear it, why am I keeping it? Number three, if it has rips, stains, holes, or faded text. And finally, when did I last wear it? I have to make sure I'm keeping clothes that I wore recently. Those last two categories have some exceptions, and you'll see what I mean when I get into the video. First things first, I have to collect all of my clothes into one giant pile in the same place. Now, I digress a little bit on the clothes in my hamper. I'm not going to mix dirty laundry with clean, and plus I know I'm keeping those. This giant pile here, as you just saw me pulling out, I've emptied my entire closet. I'm now going to add the dresser drawers onto it. There are a few drawers I haven't pulled out yet, but we'll do those after I get rid of the main pile. So when it comes to going through that pile, I'm going to be making three smaller piles. First pile is for clothes I'm definitely keeping. Second pile is for clothes I'm definitely getting rid of. And third pile is for clothes I'm keeping, but not to wear. I want to turn them into scrap fabric for DIYs or whatever. Let's jump into the first article. Top of the pile, we have this dress here. I haven't worn it in a while, but it definitely sparks joy. My grad dress from both grade 9 and grade 12. I'm definitely keeping it. So it goes in the keeping pile. This here I rarely wear, but I'm also definitely keeping it. It's really cute, it definitely sparks joy, and it's also from Mexico. It was Walmart, but it's from Mexico. This I've never even worn once. It can just go in the goodbye pile. Haven't worn this in a while, but I love it. It's a nice over shirt accessory. You want to look a little more fancy. Definitely keeping that. Another over shirt accessory. I haven't been wearing this mostly because of COVID and I've been staying at home minus my walks, But when school starts back up, at days or whatever, I'll definitely wear these again. So keep. Okay, another piece that I want to talk with you is this ankle length skirt. I very much like the colors and the pattern, but I rarely ever wear it. I think the last time was my birthday party, and so that's almost a year ago as of now. And plus, I don't want to have my thighs rub. I always have to wear pants under it. So we can add this to the goodbye pile. And now I'm just gonna jump into my time lapse. We'll go through these next pieces a little quicker. Coming out of time lapse, I just want to say that I'm actually gonna make a short pile for maybe, and we'll go through those again at the end to determine whether the nose or yes is official. This sweater I'm actually going to try on, just to make certain that it is too small, I think, before I get rid of it. I like it because purple matches purple, such as today, but if it's too small, why do I keep it, like I said. Yeah, that's definitely tight. I can't even zip it fully, so goodbye. This is a no. Here we have a different purple sweater. Let's do a try-on portion of this one. I'm pretty sure it fits, but let's be certain. Ugh. It's feeling tight. We're gonna go with no for this one as well. This piece here, this blue sweater, is an example of an exception article. If you look closely on it, right here, and some other spots as well, like here, it has a couple of holes, but those holes are campfire sparks. When I was up at Westover, the fire jumped onto my sweater. I was fine, but now there's a hole in the sweater. And I know I said holes mean to get rid of, but I've still been wearing this. I still love it. It's an exception, it passes to the keeping pile. For this next sweater, this one here, which does spark joy and I am keeping it, actually has a really funny story to it. So I was at the mall shopping with one of my friends, and I wasn't sure if a kangaroo sweater would be inappropriate at my age. So I texted my mom and said, hey, can I buy a kangaroo sweater? She says yes, so I bought it. And then when I get home and show her, she was not expecting this number at all, because apparently this style of pocket here is called the kangaroo pocket. I didn't know that, but I still love this sweater, so I'm keeping it. This sweater from Aeropostale, one of my favorite brands, definitely a keeper. Aeropostale is like the best. And speaking of Aeropostale, here's a shirt you'll probably recognize if you watched my Light of the Village haul video. So we're keeping that for sure. So that in the keep pile. And let's keep going. This shirt here is very basic, but I'm still gonna keep it because it's a perfect shirt for underneath that green cardigan I showed you at the beginning. This shirt, I'm definitely keeping. It's my business shirt, my logo. If you have not checked me out and you want some clothes for your 18-inch doll, yeah, terrago.com, I'll link it. I don't usually shop at Pink, But I saw this at Value Village one of the times that I'd gone, and I had to get it because it's comfortable, it's cozy, it's adorable. This text is faded, but it's not faded enough. So I'm going to continue keeping it. Love you to the moon and back in the yes pile. The next shirt, I will be doing a try on portion just to help jog my memory of what I think about it, but it's probably going to be a no article. I like the hood on it. Most t-shirts don't have hoods. Yeah, I was right. Yeah, no. I'm going to decide to get rid of this. I don't like how the thumb holes are in the wrong spot naturally. You have to twist the fabric to get it, and then it feels weird. So we're going to nix this article.
Eyes in the sky, gazing far into the night. I raise my hand to the fire, but it's no use, 'cause you can't stop it from shining through. It's true, baby.
This one, the this shirt is from a brand called Justice. I don't shop there very often because most of the clothes don't fit me and I'm wearing too big. But this still does, so I love it and I'm keeping it. And another Justice one, I can find in the pile. This is really good. This piece up here is also Justice, and my last two fitting Justice pieces. It's a very cute, colorful doll. Also, you can tell how much I've worn it. I thought it was stretched and whatever from when I didn't even purchase it. But yeah, I'm definitely keeping both of these sets from the pile. This sweater is my newest sweater, but it is definitely one of my favorites. It's my new Girl Guide sweater. I love it so much. I wear it to all the meetings, and I also just wear it out and about casually. It is incredibly warm. Love this. So worth the purchase. This shirt I bought in Chile when we were on our vacation. I used to have a blue one, but I got rid of it because I got a hole. This one is the only surviving article I've gotten in Chile, because both pants have also been gotten rid of. This shirt here I am most definitely keeping. It's very soft, it's very cute, 3/4 sleeve, hood, and ties. Most importantly, I bought at Value Village for roughly $7. But it is a Michael Kors shirt. I checked their website and similar items are selling in the hundreds of dollars. So I think that's a flippin steal. We're keeping that. Baby, let the light shine through. If you believe it's true, baby, won't you let the light shine through? Is a man named Fernando Botero, and this here is his fat horse on a shirt. I love all of his paintings so much when you love the medium. It seems to be one of my favorite artists, and I especially love his fat horses, so I just had to get this shirt. I love it so much. First door, first door. This here is another item that definitely sparks joy. I haven't worn them in a while because it's been summer, but They are from El Paso 87 pink sweatpants. They're a little short for me, so I use them as PJs, but they're El Paso, and I love them so much. I haven't worn them that often, but I need to get doing that more frequently. However, speaking of sweatpants, these ones, I'm going to turn them into a no. As much as I love them, they're also too small. And yes, I turn them into PJs, but I don't love them as much as the Air Hostel. So since I have plenty of PJ pants, and I never choose to wear them anyway, I'm just going to say no to them. Here is a no for keeping. Originally, it was a definitive yes, an exception to the stain rule because it's pajamas, but as you'll notice here, there is now a massive hole in the side of the shirt, so I'm going to be getting rid of it. We have a matching Adidas tracksuit, the pants and the sweater. I wear the pants more frequently than I wear the sweater, but I am definitely keeping both. And I quite like the set. This shirt here is from when my grandma and grandpa went to Hawaii on vacation. I can't remember how many years I've had it. It's been like 5 or 6 at least. And you can see that the letters are like 99% gone. It's practically just a plain purple shirt. So technically I should get rid of it due to the fading rule. But it's worth doing because from them, I love it. I wear all the time as PJs, and because of PJs, that's why it passes as a yes. This shirt I've had for so long that it used to be a nightgown on me, and now it's just a long t-shirt. But that's how long I've owned this shirt for. It used to be a nightgown, and now it's just a shirt. But I rarely wear it. I choose other PJ shirts way more frequently, so I think we'll just thank it for the service and get rid of it. It was meant to have lasted. This shirt is a definite keeper. It's my Mitad del Mundo, or Equator shirt, from Ecuador. We went to the Equator. I have a whole vlog on that, I'll link below. Love this shirt. I wear it all the time. These pajama pants I have not worn in a long time. But that's because it's been summer, and look at how fuzzy they are. Who wants to wear this when it's 20 degrees Celsius outside? Anyway, I definitely spark joy, I'm definitely going to keep them, and I'm definitely going to wear them once winter comes up. They're also a really good pants for camping, to keep you warm in your tent of the night. And next, I want to show you just how many different plain colored t-shirts I own. Here's me right now wearing a purple one. So obviously it's a keeper, I'm wearing it and keeping it. Next up we have this pink one. That's a keeper. A lighter pink. Also keeping. A green. That's the trend, I'm keeping it. A darker green. I love this one a lot. Probably one of my favorite of the plain color shirts. But I also really quite like this blue one here. Got a light blue one. And lastly, I have this navy one. I love this one, but it has some bleach stains or whatever the heck this is on this one. So it's going in my scrap fabric pile. I can look around the stains and make some more of it. So we're not keeping it. Just all other ones are keeping it. This has a couple of holes in it, but I wear them all the time, and they get an exception because they're pajamas. So I'm not pretending that all the things get the exception, and I'm talking about them all. I love this shirt here, my Appleton Estate rum shirt. Funny thing about this is I actually wore it in a video for a school project. I wore my alcohol shirt and handed in an assignment, but it's fine. It didn't affect our mark at all. No one really cared about promoting alcohol as a ninth grader. Got this one to match my Wonder Woman one. Okay, not really, but they're both DC heroes. My guest pile of clothes is so large comparatively that it literally toppled over and shifted the tripod, and I had to fix the angle, but anyway, we're back at it. Classic black leggings, you gotta have one of those. I love these pants because they actually have pockets. The main reason I bought them was to be my special wrestler pants and need this kind of material for the canoeing. Yeah. It's not really clean. This year, definitely first day. It is my senior band tour shirt from middle school in 2014. I think it was grade 7, I want to say. We went to Alberta and BC for various concerts and doing some of the jazz. It was very, very fun. Next up we have my jeans. I have not touched any of these four pairs since we went into COVID quarantine, but I do plan to wear them again once I'm going to more people's places, like school coming back up a state. I'm assuming that they fit. I'm going to do a try on, and I'm keeping all of them. The green, the maroon, what's it called? Purple, whatever the heck it is. The tan, and the blue jean. The blue jean is a different brand. Then these are one brand, and this is a different one. Next we have business casual pants. They don't spark joy, but like I said, they ain't so, we need them. They have a good job. What am I supposed to wear? You want the gray pair? A black pair. And a different black pair. Keeping all three of those. So we've now gone through the entire pile on the bed. I'm just gonna bring my maybes back up and reassess them as no's or yeses before I bring in the final segment of clothes. Alright, so I wanna walk you through my maybes pile. Here we have this leopard print sweater. I quite like it. And I'm mainly using it as PJ, so you can pass all the sections. But it's very yellowy. And the strings are not even, this is my knot that I've turned them and stuck in one side. I don't know. When I have some other choices, why would I want to wear this one? I'm just gonna go with no. Thank you for doing your job. Goodbye. This here's in the maybes because it looks like I like it. I don't wear it very often. Just, I don't know, not quite sparking a joy, so we're gonna get rid of it. Thank you for your serving your purpose. I have plenty of shirts. This one's in the maybe, because I'm not sure how big of a deal I want to call that stain. But now I'm noticing like three more stains, so goodbye. Thank you for serving your purpose. this shirt is a maybe because I'm wearing it. It's been a long time since. But I think I'll go with yes and keep it because Halloween came up and there are two kinds of bedroom visions out of the same glass and skull that would be a perfect outfit. So I'm gonna go with yes on it. Plus now I have my shirt on zipper. This pair of shorts here and this pair of shorts here are both in my maybes because I'm not much of a short person. If it's warm weather, I prefer my capris or a thinner leggings. So I'm pretty much in the leggings. So for the next category, we have outerwear, undergarments, custom fit, and socks. First thing I want to mention is I'm not going to show you my winter coats or my sweatpants, but just know that I'm keeping both jackets and the pants. I need them, so we're keeping them. Let's get going on the drawers. We'll start over here with outerwear. Brand new Girl Guide beanie that I wear to all the meetings. Yes, keeping. This beanie from Valdivia, which I think is Chile. I should know this, but I'm blanking. Love this hat, wear it all the time. Keeping. This hat, yeah, it lost a string, and this string's been shortened. But I've had this hat as long as I can remember. I love it. So we're definitely keeping it. I'll wear it all the time in winter. Here's a neck warmer. It's a fancy different sticker, but it's not the staple when it gets cold, so we're keeping that. Here's a pair of mittens. Nothing fancy about them, but keeping. I'm also going to keep both of these. They're thicker than the black ones. I have pink and again pink, but they're in two different styles, depending on if I'd rather have mittens or gloves. This here is a scarf. Very nice, pretty floral color, but I'm not a scarf person. I'll probably give it back to my mom because I think that's a lot of them. I'll put it in another style and show it to that later. And then here I have two different buffs. One is Helly Hansen that I got at the Dance Film Festival, someone gave it to me. And then this here is Sunshine Village. I got it from my Sunshine Village ski lessons. Don't wear them all the time, but I think we will keep both of those. And maybe this month I can use them. Coming over here to my undergarments drawer. I've got my COVID masks in this drawer. I've got my sling from the time I broke my wrist. If you haven't watched that video, I'll again link another one for you. I don't know why I'm keeping this, but I am. Maybe because I think it's useful or something. I'm not going to put it in the nose pile and see what people want to do with it. Keep it, throw it away, whatever. This bra I hate, but it's the only one that looks good with my grad dress. So I should probably continue keeping it. But I'm going to put it in the nose pile and see what happens. If people force me to keep it, then I'll keep it. Here's my swimsuit and my sun shirt. Haven't worn it in a while, but then again, that's because I haven't been swimming. It's a very niche product, so I'm definitely keeping it. It's extremely beautiful. As for my other bras, keep all three of them. And for my underwear, I would rather not show you, but I'm going to keep all of them. Even though there's three pairs I don't wear as frequently, I just like to have them. And lastly, over to socks. I have a bunch of pairs of just classic ankle socks. Here's three. Here's two more that I wear all the time. I'll keep all of them and only get rid of them in the future once they have holes or missing pairs. These I definitely love, my fuzzy socks that I got for Christmas. The spiky gray one and the purple orange one. Keeping that. These socks are like really thin, layered cotton skinnies. Got them for a pair of boots that I no longer have, but I occasionally use them, so I should keep them. I'm not taking up anything in the drawer. These socks here, I think they're wool. They're itchy, and I hate them. But I do wear this pair occasionally. So, I'm going to keep the one and get rid of the other. We also have these socks here with the grip that are extremely long. They're probably like knee high or more. are very nice, but I haven't worn them in a while. So I think, given all my other prices, I might want to still have them. But for now, I'm just going to leave this pile on the mat. This pair of coconut socks I love. My dad gave them to me. They're Microsoft socks, if you look at them. I love these. Here are some ski socks. They're a nice height to wear in my hiking boots. And also a good hiking boot sock is this pair here. I've got two of the same thing. For now, I'll go with yes on these tall socks. See what happens as we get into winter. And if I don't wear them frequently enough, they'll become a no in the future. This pile is freaking massive. I am not going to recap that for you, but I will recap the scrap fabric and no piles. For scrap fabric, we have this navy blue t-shirt. I can work around the stains. We have this too small pair of sweatpants, ombre sweatpants in sunset colors. And we have the Perry the Platypus t-shirt. I figure I can cut around the logo, and when I make Taryn's minion blanket finally, with a different cutout shirt, I can double-side it with a Perry blanket, and it'll be a whole cool thing. So that's my scrap fabric pile. For my no pile, we have this pair of socks. I hate them. They're itchy. They're woolly. So I only kept one of the two. I do wear that on occasionally, but I still hate it. Either way, I need it. We have the sling for my broken wrist. Crappy nude bra. A scarf that I'm giving back to the original owner because I'm not a scarf person. This overshirt thing that I've never worn in my life. A skirt. Two pairs of shorts. This purple sweater. This other purple sweater. This pink could be a sweater, could also be a shirt thing with the thumb holes in the hood. Nightgown. T-shirt that I don't like or it has stains or both. Sweater that I no longer wear because it's yellowing and the strings are weird. And lastly, my Ranger shirt. I do still want to keep this because I'm trying to sell it, but I'm going to find a home for it. There's not space in my drawers. And that's everything. That is my entire wardrobe, no or yes. I'm not going to film this part just to save space and time, but gotta put everything away now. I just finished putting away all of my clothes. The closet looks much nicer, and so do the drawers. Getting rid of that stuff cleared up space, and they also organized more efficiently. Right, that concludes this video where I KonMari method my entire wardrobe. If you liked it, please drop one down below. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any future content. Follow me on all of my social medias linked in the description. And aloha till next time.